and then it's twice around, isn't it?
It's interesting because I think the starting point for the story for me came a lot later than for Chris, because although we were dating for quite a while, I really saw the relationship as a bit of fun. He was my in-betweener. I'd come out of a long relationship, and so I wasn't looking for anything else. And I was very set on that path of not wanting something else. It was a fairly kind of rapid realisation when it did come, you know, months after we'd started seeing each other, the realisation of what I had with him wasn't just a bit of fun that I thought it was. That realisation came, I kind of tripped over it. It wasn't something that was a long, drawn-out process. I did practically trip over the realisation that I was just in love with him.
See what I'm saying?
Yeah, the cleavage does it all, does it? You got a shot of Emma's cleavage. Now then. Now.
Right.
Avert your eyes, Roy. Okay. Now. I am wearing them.
Okay. Now, we've known each other for 10 years, but never had any attraction at all for 7 years of that. Quite strange how suddenly an attraction can spark into life, even when you've known someone for that long. And really, I don't think either of us had anything there before 3.5 years ago or so.
Look, as far as you need to go on, I am a surrender wife and I learn everything I know from this lady here. And by the way, then from Elaine, whole surrender wife thingy.
Because I'm such a good example.
Is it just the one? How do your boys look? Do they look handsome?
They do.
Are they suited and booted?
Steve's got a new shirt.
Yeah.
New belt, a new suit.
This is what Ian gave me as best man at his wedding 10 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
So,
I should be
wearing this today. You got yours already in?
Oh, of course.
Excellent.
Well, I suppose if I'm going to try and pin the change down, I have to try and think about why I was the way I was before. I mean, the way I illustrate it would be walk into a room, look around, clock everyone, clock all the men immediately. That's the first thing I would do in a room. And when talking to men, there was the constant possibility of something happening with them if I wished, regardless of whether I was in a relationship or not. It didn't really seem to matter to me whether I was in a relationship or not. It would make no difference.
The big one for us getting to know each other was went to Vietnam together in October 2000. I found a very, very easy company, very easy travelling companion. I like the fact that she could adapt very well to different places and different people and situations, and enjoy all those different situations. And what really attracted me very, very definitely, which again I hadn't seen before, was this amazing enthusiasm she has for so many things that you take for granted and don't probably get excited about, and she still does this. I love it, and I think that really kind of touched me, definitely.
Oh yeah, but I tested it out and it still ran, so I'm just going to put a little bit on the tips. I'm hardly going to know it anyway. Ladies, here's a toast to love and friendship. Love and friendship. Cheers.
I really enjoy our relationship. What I most enjoy about it is that often when people talk about love or people are in love, it can be something that they have no control over. they've fallen in love and they're just tied to that person and they can't do anything about it, and they don't know, you know, they don't know why they love them, they just do. I know exactly why I love him. I fell in love with him with my eyes open. I didn't become besotted with him and then just be, you know, dragged into a relationship. It makes it very special for me to actually know that I'm in a relationship completely with my eyes open. Having someone who meets all your different needs on all your different levels. You wake up in the morning and you think, wow, this is great. It's a delight just to be in the relationship, but also to look at the relationship we have. And it's quite sad to admit that no one has really captured my heart before Chris, but in a way it's also very nice.
Should we get outside?
Yeah, I did, fuck as well.
Should, can we get under there as well?
I bet you could as well.
No one will notice you.
I've never met anyone in my life that it felt right with. I never even thought of asking anyone to marry me and spend the rest of their life with me. Never really crossed my mind. With Tam, it's been quite different. It feels totally natural to want to spend the rest of my life with her. I cannot imagine wanting to be with anyone else. She makes me incredibly happy. She lights up my life.
Onto the bottom
one, yeah.
And then the two sides, then hook over that as well. It's reinforced.
Right, okay.
And then I can walk around, you know, without.
I had it in my mind, probably a lot before her, that I could see us together. I had it clear fairly quickly after meeting her again that if something changed in her current life, then I wanted to be there to go forward with her and in my life. I could see her as my partner, very definitely.